Good morning, students. Today we are going to study the image formation. In our last class, we have studied the rules of the images formed by the spherical mirrors. Okay, last class mein humne kya padha tha? The rules of the images that are formed by the spherical mirrors. And today we are going to discuss the image formation. So, image ki या हम कहें spherical mirrors की अलग अलग पोजिशन पर ऑब्जेक्ट के होने से इमेज पर क्या वेरिएशंस आते हैं दैट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी. ओके, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द इमेज फॉर्मेशन इन केस ऑफ कॉनकेव मिरर. नाउ द फर्स्ट केस इज वेर योर ऑब्जेक्ट इज एट इंफिनिटी. देन व्हाट काइंड ऑफ इमेज इज फॉर्म्ड दैट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी. नाउ दिस इज योर कॉनकेव मिरर, राइट? As it is polished from outside, so we know that the mirror which is polished from outside is called the concave mirror, right? This is the principal axis. Let P be the pole, F be the focus, and C be the center of curvature. So, as we all know that if our object is at infinity, then let a ray that is parallel to the principal axis is incident onto the mirror, and we know that by the rule that a ray, if any ray is incidenting parallel to the principal axis on the mirror, then after reflection it will pass through focus. Okay, similarly another ray will incident parallel to the principal axis, and after reflection it will also pass through focus. And we know that the point at which two reflected rays meet each other, at that point we get our image, right? So here at this point two reflected rays are meeting each other, so we get our image at focus. What is the size of the image formed? As we can see in the figure, it is point size, hai na? जो इमेज बनी है उसका साइज कैसा है? इट इज पॉइंट साइज, मतलब एक बिंदु बराबर. नाउ व्हाट इज द नेचर ऑफ द इमेज फॉर्म्ड? इट इज रियल एंड इन्वर्टेड. वी नो दैट द रियल इमेज इज ऑलवेज इन्वर्टेड, एज आई हैव टॉट यू अर्लियर ऑल्सो. एंड when the two reflected rays actually meet each other, then we get the real image. So here the two reflected rays are actually meeting at a point, at this point. So the image formed in this case is real and inverted. So I hope this figure must be clear to all of you. Now we are going to discuss the second case. In the second case, your object will come closer to the mirror and its new position will be between infinity and C, where C is the center of curvature. So what is the new position of our object? It is between infinity and C, or we can say that your object is beyond C. Okay, आपका object कहाँ पर है? C के पीछे, that is beyond C. Again, this is our concave mirror. As it is polished from outside, this is the principal axis, ये हो गया pole, this is focus, and this is center of curvature. Okay, now here at this point you are having your object, यहां कहीं आपका object है. A ray will incident parallel to the principal axis, and you know that if the ray is incidenting parallel to the principal axis, then after reflection it will pass through focus, right? Now another ray be incidenting through center of curvature, and we know that if the ray is incidenting through center of curvature, then after reflection it will follow the same path from where it has entered. So here at this point we get the two reflected rays meet each other. So here at this point we get our image, which is real and inverted. Its position is between C and F, that is between center of curvature and focus. And the image so formed is smaller than the object. So I hope this must be clear to all of you. Now we are going to discuss the third case, that is अब आपका जो ऑब्जेक्ट है वो और पास में आ जाएगा एंड इन द नेक्स्ट केस योर ऑब्जेक्ट विल बी एट सेंटर ऑफ कर्वेचर. ओके, नाउ योर ऑब्जेक्ट इज एट सेंटर ऑफ कर्वेचर. योर ऑब्जेक्ट इज एट सेंटर ऑफ कर्वेचर. दिस इज योर कॉनकेव मिरर. लेट दिस बी द प्रिंसिपल एक्सिस, पी बी द पोल, F be the focus and C be the center of curvature. If I make an arrow here, let this be my object which is at center of curvature. A ray will incident parallel to the principal axis and after reflection it will pass through focus. As we know that this is a rule, right? Now another ray will incident through focus. And we know that the ray which incident through focus, after reflection, it will pass parallel to the principal axis. And here at this point, we get our image. Okay? So, hamari image kahan bani? The image is formed at center of curvature, that is C. It is of same size as that of object. Jo object ka size hoga, वही आपकी इमेज का भी साइज होगा. इसका नेचर कैसा होगा? इट इज रियल एंड इनवर्टेड. सो आई होप दिस फिगर मस्ट बी क्लियर टू ऑल ऑफ यू. नाउ द फोर्थ केस दैट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस. अब नेक्स्ट केस में क्या होगा? आपका ऑब्जेक्ट और ज्यादा पास में आ जाएगा एंड इट्स न्यू पोजिशन विल बी बिटवीन हियर सी एंड एफ. ओके, सो इन द नेक्स्ट केस your object will be between C and F, that is center of curvature and focus. Let this be the concave mirror, this be the principal axis, ये हो गया pole, ये focus और ये center of curvature. Now your object is between C and F. Okay, आपका object कहाँ है? C और F के बीच में. A ray will incident parallel to the principal axis. After reflection, it will pass through focus, as this is a rule, right? Now, another ray will incident through focus. After reflection, it will pass parallel to the principal axis. And here, at this point, you will get your image, okay? That is beyond C. So, आपको इमेज कहां मिली है? द इमेज इज फॉर्मड बियॉन्ड सी. इट इज बिगर देन द ऑब्जेक्ट. एंड व्हाट इज द नेचर? इट्स नेचर इज रियल एंड इनवर्टेड. सो आई होप द फिगर मस्ट बी क्लियर टू ऑल ऑफ यू. नाउ द नेक्स्ट केस दैट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इज, अब आपका ऑब्जेक्ट क्या होगा? Its new position will be at focus. Your object's new position will be at focus now. अब आपके object की जो नई position है वो क्या है? Focus पे. Same चीज हमको करनी है. Let this be the concave mirror. As it is polished from outside. This be the principal axis. ये हो गया pole. This is focus and this is center of curvature. क्या बोल रहे हैं? कि हमको object कहाँ पर रखना है? It should be at the focus. Okay, so a ray will incident parallel to the principal axis and after reflection it will pass through focus. Okay, now another ray will incident through center of curvature like this. If the ray is incidenting through center of curvature, then after reflection, it will follow the same path from where it has entered. We know this, right? If I extend these rays on both the sides. Will they intersect each other? No, they will never intersect each other. Why? Because these both rays are parallel rays, and we know that parallel rays do not intersect each other. Okay, so we assume that on some point at infinity these rays will meet each other, and we get our image at that point, that is at focus. Okay, अब फोकस पे जो इमेज बनेगी वो कैसी होगी? इट विल बी हाईली एनलार्ज्ड, एंड द इमेज फॉर्म एट फोकस वी अज्यूम दैट इट विल बी रियल एंड इनवर्टेड, सिंस द रेज विल एक्चुअली मीट ईच अदर एट सम पॉइंट इन एट द इंफिनिटी, वी अज्यूम दिस. सो दिस इज द केस वेयर वी डू गेट अवर इमेज एट इंफिनिटी when our object is at focus. Okay, now the last case of the concave mirror that we are going to study is when your object is between infinity and P, where F is the focus and P is the pole. The last case of the concave mirror is that this is your concave mirror, this be the pole, this be focus, and this be center of curvature. Okay, your object is between focus and pole. Now a light ray will incident parallel to the principal axis. After reflection it will pass through focus. Okay, now another ray will incident through center of curvature like this. If I extend both the rays to any point, these rays will never intersect each other as they are diverging from each other, hai na? Since these two rays are diverging from each other, so they will never intersect each other. But if I do extend back both these rays beyond the mirror, so here at this point I will get my image. Okay, this is the point where do I'll get my image. This is the case where the image formed is virtual and erect. Is case mein kaisi image banegi? Virtual and erect. It will be bigger than the object. And what is its position? Its position will be beyond the mirror. So I hope the figure must be clear to all of you. Now similarly there are the two cases which are related to the convex mirror that we are going to study in our next class. Okay students, that's all for today's class. The further topics we are going to study in the next class. In our last class we have discussed the image formation in case of concave mirror. Okay, today we are going to discuss the image formation in case of convex mirror. The image formation in case of convex mirror. In case of concave mirror we have six possible cases, but while talking about the convex mirror we have to study only two cases. Okay, the first case is when your object is at infinity. Okay, when your object is at infinity, so let this be the convex mirror as it is polished from inside and its reflecting surface is bulging outside. Okay, this is the principal axis, right? Let P be the pole. Okay, now a ray be incident parallel to the principal axis. After reflection it will go such that it is appears to be coming from the focus. Okay, हमको पता है कि जब भी कोई लाइट रे प्रिंसिपल एक्सिस के पैरेलल आती है तो इन केस ऑफ कॉन्वेक्स मिरर इट अपीयर्स टू बी कमिंग फ्रॉम फोकस, राइट? सो Similarly, let another ray be incidenting parallel to the principal axis like this, and it will get reflected like this. On extending back this ray, I will get the two reflected rays meeting each other at this point, है ना? So I will get my image at this point, which is at focus. Okay, I will get the image at focus. It is point size image. कैसी इमेज बनेगी? It is of point size and it will be virtual and erect, right? Because here the rays are not actually meeting each other, but we have to pretend that these rays are meeting at this point, है ना? We have to extend them back. So the image so formed in this case is virtual and erect. So this was the case when your object is at infinity. Now the second case that we are going to discuss is, in second case, your object is at any position in front of convex mirror. If your object is at any position in front of convex mirror, then what will happen? Let us see. This is a convex mirror as it is polished from inside and its reflecting surface is outside. Yeah. Now, if I draw, this will be my principal axis. Let P be the pole, F be the focus, and C be the center of curvature. Let a ray be incidenting parallel to the principal axis. So, after reflection, it will go like this. That on extending it back, it is appears to be coming from the focus, right? अगर मैं इसको extend back करूं, तो ये क्या लगेगा कि ये ray जो है वो focus से आ रही है. Now, let another ray, अच्छा, this is our object, okay? Now, let another ray be incidenting on the pole, and we know that the ray which get incident on the pole, it will go like this by following the law that I is equal to R, है ना? जितना angle यहाँ पे बनेगा, उतना ही angle यहाँ पर भी बनेगा. And if I extend back this ray, then here at this point, I will get the two reflected rays meet each other and I will get my image at this point, है ना? So what is the nature of the image formed? It is virtual and erect. It is smaller than the object. Object से छोटी बनी है. It is smaller than object. And its position will be between P and F. Okay? Its position will be between P and F. So, this is the case when the image is formed in front of, when the object is placed at any position in front of convex mirror. Okay? Convex mirror के case में object किसी भी पोजीशन पर हो हमेशा आपको इसी टाइप की इमेज मिलेगी. सो कॉन्वेक्स मिरर में हमको केवल दो टाइप की इमेजेस पढ़नी थी. दैट इज व्हेन योर ऑब्जेक्ट इज एट इनफिनिटी एंड द सेकंड वन इज व्हेन योर ऑब्जेक्ट इज इन फ्रंट ऑफ कॉन्वेक्स मिरर एट एनी पोजीशन. सो दीज आर द टू केसेस ऑफ इमेज फॉर्मेशन. वी हैव डिस्कस्ड सिक्स केसेस ऑफ इमेज फॉर्मेशन इन केस ऑफ कॉनकेव मिरर एंड टू केसेस इन केस ऑफ कॉन्वेक्स मिरर. नाउ द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक दैट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी. In our previous classes, I have told you about one rule of the image formed by the plane mirror, and which is that to get your full image in the plane mirror, the height of the mirror should be at least half of height of yourself, है ना? मैंने आपको plane mirror के case में image formation का एक case बताया था कि अगर आपको आपकी पूरी image एक mirror में देखनी है, एक intense image देखनी है, तो the height of mirror should be at least half of height of yourself. This we are going to prove mathematically, okay? Height of mirror should be half of height of person. This thing we are going to prove. For this, let us consider one figure. Let A, B, C be the person standing in front of the plane mirror लेट द नेम ऑफ द मिरर बी M1 M2। ओके, हमने मान लिया कि एबीसी कोई पर्सन है जो कि इस प्लेन मिरर M1 M2 के सामने खड़ा है। नाउ अ रे विल इंसिडेंट फ्रॉम ए, अ रे विल इंसिडेंट फ्रॉम ए एंड इट विल स्ट्राइक एट पॉइंट M1 इफ आई ड्रॉ अ परपेंडिकुलर ऑन टू दिस पॉइंट M1, देन दिस रे विल गो लाइक दिस बाय फॉलोइंग द लॉ दैट इज I1 is equal to R1, right? Now, another ray be incident from C onto point M2. If I draw a plane like this, the perpendicular, then after reflection, it will go like this. And this will be I2 and this will be R2, okay? If I extend back all these rays, then I will get my image formed as A dash, B dash, C dash into the mirror, okay? So this is how our image is formed in the mirror. Now we are going to prove this thing mathematically. For this, as we can see in the diagram, that angle AM1B is equal to angle BM1. Okay, let it be MN. Okay, हमने इसको नाम दे दिया MN. So एंगल ए एम वन एम इज इक्वल टू एंगल बी एम वन एम. ओके, एस आई इज इक्वल टू आर, दैट इज द एंगल ऑफ इंसिडेंस इज इक्वल टू एंगल ऑफ रिफ्लेक्शन, वी नो दिस. सो एंगल ए एम वन एम इज इक्वल टू एंगल बी एम वन एम. एंड वी नो वन प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ अ ट्राइंगल, दैट द साइड्स अपोजिट टू इक्वल एंगल्स आर equal. So we can say that the side opposite to this angle is AM is equal to MB. Right? We can say this, that this side is opposite to this angle. So angle AM1M ke opposite jo side hogi, that is AM is equal to angle BM1M ke opposite jo side hogi, that is MB. So AM is equal to MB, or I can say that AM is equal to MB is equal to half of AB, right? Give it equation number 1. This one, till this must be clear to all of you, right? Now similarly, we can see in the triangle angle CM2N is equal to angle BM2N. As we can see in this figure, that angle CM2N is equal to angle BM2N. So we can say that the angle opposite to this angle CM2N, that is CN, is equal to BN, or like this I can say CN is equal to BN is equal to half of BC. This is your second equation, right? Now from the figure, can I write this MN is equal to M1 M2? I can write it like this, right? MN is equal to M1 M2 from figure. From figure, I can write this MN is equal to M1, M2. Now, I can write this MN as, I can write this MN as MB plus BN. क्या मैं इस MN को MB plus BN लिख सकता हूँ? या The MN is formed by M by combining MB and BN together. So I will write this MB plus BN in place of MN. So on putting the value of MB from equation 1, I will get MB is equal to half of AB plus on putting the value of BN, I will get half of BC. If I take the half common from both the terms, then I will get half of AB plus BC and half of, if I write this half as it is, then AB plus BC. If I combine this AB and BC together, then what I will get? I will get the whole AC, right? And this is equal to what? M1, M2. So I can write M1, M2 is equal to half of AC, which is what? You can see it from here, hai na, uske aage. M1, M2 is equal to half of AC. So we can write it, the height of mirror is equal to the half of height of person. Hence we can say that for the height, to see the full image of yourself into the mirror, the height of mirror should be at least half of height of yourself. This is the case by which we can prove the thing that we have studied theoretically. Okay, students, that's all for today's session. Thank you.